limits.
Yeah.
To ensure that you are not yet too comatose from copious drinking of the mead or ale, if you be a noble and upstanding knight, please give us a huzzah.
Huzzah!
And now, if you be a fair and demure lady, give us a huzzah.
Huzzah!
And now, if you disapprove of crass medieval gender stereotyping, give us a huzzah.
Huzzah!
Ah, verily, we are dealing with a Cambridge student audience, I see. Tonight, we, these seven noble players and one tinkler of the keys.
Six.
Oh, okay,
seven.
I was.
Verily, thou art forgetting he is a player or so.
We bring you a title of a tale that is often told in these parts. Why, it is called The 1971 Green Buick Riviera of Woe and Omelettes.
Verily, could thou repeat it? I was unclear of the details of this tale.
How could you be? The title of the It is the 1971 Green Buick Riviera of Woe and Omelettes.
Riviera of Omelettes.
I know not of the definitions of 50% of those words. But, indeed, our somewhat anachronistic tale unfolds in a humble blacksmith's where a wizened old blacksmith has been working long and hard with his young and upstanding apprentice by his side. Now, this old blacksmith did not care for the new ways, newfangled technology. So when his young apprentice came to him with designs for an internal combustion engine, the blacksmith beat him and threw him out at once. Long did the apprentice travel, lonely and weary, across lands to a distant and wild dimension, until he stumbled upon a fair Riviera.
Oh, Riviera! With your features! Beautiful spurts and glimmering starlight!
Yes, this was a statue of the famed goddess, Riviera. It was known to respond to the woe of any traveller who should come across her, and respond by laying a beautiful egg. With this egg, our young apprentice knew at once he had the missing ingredient of not only a delicious omelette, but also his designs for a 1971 green Buick. And we see him now toiling to smelt the ore from the very ground beneath his feet in order to produce the most masterful automobile that had ever been seen in these fair lands. Before long, his 1971 Buick was complete. And he sat Needless to say, the horse-mounted armies of all the lands bowed in fear at the arrival of this incredibly stylish automobile. And they had no choice but to pronounce our young apprentice king, where he reigned over the lands, revolutionized the production processes for the better, forever.
You can have one in any color, as long as it's green.
Oh, a moving tale indeed.
Wasn't it? Wasn't it? One of my favourites.
Well, indeed, much of our culture is based on the knowledge of the 1971 Green Buick Riviera of War and Omelette. But I feel these people desire to hear a newer tale.
A newer tale?
A newer tale that lasts a lot longer than the famous tale you've told. I want people to call that out and speak.
What? A 55-minute long tale? No one would want to see such a thing.
I believe they would. If you would wish to see such a thing, cry huzzah!
Huzzah!
Ha-ha!
Yeah, yeah. There's one thing we've learned. This audience will huzzah at anything you say.
Surprise tears! Please move to the back while I tell our beautiful audience the tale of the minstrel's palimpsest. Written on and then rubbed out that writing, then written again. Much like happened to this. Palimpsest is a scroll that is written many times.
Thank you, kind anonymous sir.
Thank you.
Thank you for your faith in us.
Apparently, this show is educational as well as entertaining. I'm glad we invited Lord Wikipedia along.
This story begins in a desolate outpost of the kingdom, where two monks are discussing business on the roof of a monastery.
I find
a craggy and desolate landscape full of windswept dead trees and moss and dead animals. Sheer 75 foot.
A large cross.
Some crows atop the cross.
Brother, I find your habit rather scandalous.
Indeed, brother, ever since the head of our monastery instituted the below-the-knee rule, I have been punished frequently. You know, I don't mind that so much.
You ever were a slave to fashion and your whims?
Oh, yes. The landscape is looking particularly beautiful today. Rotting elephants. And those vultures playing on the rotting elephants.
Brother, is it not the case that nearly 2 weeks ago the herds of elephants rampaged cheerfully through the land beneath our monastery?
Indeed, Brother Maynard, there's been a plague upon this land. A literal plague, that's what's killing the elephants. The elephants have got the plague. And when the elephants die, they get eaten by the vultures, who now have the plague. And then when the vultures die, they become the grass. And then the lions eat the grass. It's infecting, the entire food chain is infected with the plague. Brother Maynard.
Like some sort of frightful circle of death.
Indeed,
I swear, from the day I arrived on this planet and blinking stepped into the world, I feared a catastrophe of this nature.
Indeed.
It could only have come from the great plague caster of the north.
You come to see the great plague caster of the north.
A festering tower!
A table strewn with runes of every unimaginable shape, and some imaginable but still really weird shapes.
A test tube with what appears to be a fetus in it.
Oh, great playcaster, I have brought you your fetus!
Midgekins! It is 3 p.m. No fetuses after 3 p.m. What have I told you?
I'm sorry, I gave you a response as I could, but the fetus shop was closed. I had to go to the next one in the next minute. Please don't beat me.
I will spare you this time, Midgekins, because I am in a good mood. I've cast a lot of plagues today.
Yes, truly, the runes shine in the shimmering light.
I didn't have that all in case you were the police.
Truly, your disguises against the police have been most effective recently.
We've seen some instances of his disguises being used.
The original one from before. You can't see anything!
I must leave.
Please, no. Man, please.
No.
Lady.
No, I'm just a Victorian woman. I'm the king of this place now. While you were away sleeping for the past 10 minutes, I decided to make myself king. We had a vote, you and I are the only citizens of this cave. And since I'm the king, I have deciding vote.
A cave in a tower, sir?
Yes.
My genius inventions.
Why have a tower or a cave when you can have both? Now, Midgekins, did you send the plague to the north?
Yes. I hovered my hands over the runes. I felt it as if it was my own hands. The plague spreading north, engulfing all of the elephants, and slowly...
I hate elephants!
Yes. Truly, as the influence of Gregia herself on the wildlife and on the fauna diminishes...
Don't bring up Gear. Me and her go way back. You're on a break, for fuck's sake.
Okay, play
since then, since she dumped me to be with God, whatever she calls him, I've had my revenge on her precious landscapes.
Oh yes, yes, your petty feud has grown
into a petty plague war!
We cut far to the north, to the great city of North City.
Plague! Truly, it is a sad day to be a citizen of the city of the north.
I'm still alive.
Would you kindly not interrupt me in the middle of my moving soliloquy about how sad it is to be a citizen of the city of the north?
I'm probably contagious.
Oh, God. What's your name, sir? What brings you to our fair city?
They call me Smocky. I'm brought to your city because when you get the plague, it makes you walk in one direction, and then you kind of collapse and start crawling in one direction. And I just found I couldn't turn.
Oh,
as I was heading north when I caught the plague, here I am.
Well, you're too late. If you wanted to see One Direction, they cancelled their tour.
I'm already dying of plague. Why would I want to see One Direction? Literally least helpful suggestion.
Verily, you are wise indeed. I recognize you. You are a monk of the neighboring monastery. Palimpsest, is that right?
Indeed. I was Brother Palimpsest until I was thrown out of our monastery for having my habit too high. And making inappropriate noises whenever the abbot whipped me.
I just swallowed inappropriate noises.
Together?
Ow! That hurts!
Oh, please, don't be so sarcastic about it! Monks.
Back to the present.
No, what you have to understand is that these lands are icy, as you can see from the skin that I've always been wearing.
Indeed, truly you are a man of the north. What is your name?
My name is simply Kluft.
Well, it seems we're having this conversation.
It's a noble and masculine name, not fit to laugh at.
What brings you to North City, Kluft?
Me? I have lived in North City all my life. Can't you tell from my rugged features, my chiselled jaw, the snow in my beard that I have?
Yes. Now, Kluft, I don't mean to be rude, but I am dying.
You're dying very alluringly, but don't mind if I say so.
Indeed.
And very revealingly at the same time.
Perhaps, if it would be too much trouble, you could bring me to a house of healing. I would make it worth your while.
You have to understand, the plague has not yet breached the walls of the city of the north. And if it does, we shall all surely perish like the outsiders. And the elephants, most regrettably, have all perished. We can't allow that, Climpestet, even though your monastery has served the city well with its scrolls and its teachings and its arcane magics that have kept our citizens healthy and happy for years.
Yes.
Times are changing. This plague is unstoppable, and unless we do something about it, I fear we must part ways with your monastery forever.
Kluft.
Yes?
Before I left the monastery, I managed to secrete one of the abbot's most important scrolls in one of my intimate bodily areas.
You didn't mind my saying so. You appear to be secreting quite enough already. You're in the very advanced stages of plague. I don't know what to look at you.
This scroll contains... Oh, my poor plague-ridden hands. That scroll contains a map. Well, the scroll is a map, right? That's how scrolls see. That gives the directions and the architect's plans for Plague Lord's castle cave tower.
Ah, yes. The quest for calipers. I see it written here on this very parchment.
The architect was nuts, man.
You think calipers will help us in the war against the plague? Is that what's buried in this distant castle?
Indeed, the Plague Lord's one weakness is buried underneath his very castle, because irony. But you
are... I'm not at all sure that's ironic. I think that might just be coincidence.
My pen and pendant is glowing red hot. There must be a pendant here. Oh, it's gone. It's died down again.
While we're on the subject, that scroll with the map on it was written by a minstrel who rubbed out everything he wrote on it. Just to save us from having to go back to that at some point.
Some kind of rubbed out and then rewritten scroll. I'm sure there's no specific word for that. Why would anyone need to use that word? This is such a niche thing to
use. What you must know, one last thing. The words originally written on that scroll before they were rubbed out and became unreadable were the magic incantation needed to free the calipers from underneath the cave town. Without them, I fear you will never, never get the item you need to defeat the Plague Lord.
That's a bit of a catch-22, isn't it?
If you can find the minstrel, fine, he still lives.
The minstrel still lives?
He's a very old man now. Like 62, it wasn't made that long ago. The cave tower was a relatively new addition.
Verily, that is...
We can't see the planning committee. We've got somebody who wants to build a monstrous dart.
Guys, there's a darts match over there.
Apparently, I know the architecture of which you speak. Truly, it is monstrous and rectilinear. I can't believe it's grade one listed.
You must find the minstrel, and he will tell you the incantation. Well, maybe he'll tell you. The incantation is what I'm saying.
Minstrel. But you know full well the City of the North has banned all music.
Indeed, and the minstrel is no longer in this place.
We cut to the minstrel, who's been imprisoned by the plague laws.
So glad we had that castle feature added to the tower cave.
Now, minstrel, I you're a minstrel, so I expect you to sing everything I ask you in this interview.
I will use my plague lord magic to create a beat. Where have you buried the calipers?
I have not buried the calipers.
I don't believe you. Yes, you have.
No, I haven't.
So let's sing a confession, sir. Stop evading me, scum. Where are the calipers? Are they up your bum?
laughter. No, please, right, don't
get
out
of us.
Let me just turn off the beat.
I know you buried the cowboys. It said so on the second scroll, which my assistant Midgekins found for me. Yes.
Oh, okay, great. No,
I really don't care. Another thing to incorporate. On the second scroll, you told me that you had burned in calipers, because the second scroll, after it was rubbed out, said, Aslan and the battle for Gara Hostel Lane Bridge.
Gara Hostel Lane Bridge.
Yes, Gara Hostel Lane Bridge. And that tells me that you did it. Aslan the Minstrel.
It's true. I am Aslan the Minstrel.
Don't think I didn't know it was you. I thought that luring you here by having the lions be part of the plague food chain. You came running to me trying to save them, and now you're in my prison part of the tower castle cave.
I underestimated you, it's true.
You underestimate me for the last time, perhaps. No, you might underestimate me again. You are in control of how you view me.
Boom! Boom! Boom!
Some of your music.
Yes, I left it on.
Boom! Boom!
Sorry, it's you.
Can you ever not sing?
No! I'm a singer, everything I want to say.
I will beat you unless you tell me where the calipers are.
The calipers I did not hide, I hid them too, it's true.
So you definitely buried the calipers?
Maybe I hid them, maybe I didn't, but I did.
We're getting at least somewhere. Where did you hide them?
Did you see a big tree?
I have in my life seen a big
tree. It is not there. Look for a blue tree by the pink tree. And it is the tree next door.
So it's the tree next to the blue tree, next to the pink tree. You're definitely not lying. You're definitely not hidden it somewhere right under my nose. I'll take your weird smile as a yes. I'll head out to the pink tree with my ability to teleport to literally anything.
We move to the court of the Empress of North City, whose name is Gaia.
Gaia, my lady, you know that...
I have watched over this fair city for the last 20 years. I have always served you, my lady, in every way I could see fit.
Yes, Clafton, you have served me well.
We see some examples of this. I've got this crossword for you.
Did Gaia get stuck again?
Yeah.
Number 9 across.
Oh, it's another time. Gaia said that you have to give me a foot rub. Didn't you, Gaia?
Sorry.
We cut.
Come on.
Car captain, come quickly. The Empress requires you to lance her bubow.
I literally never get a chance to actually do any guarding, but fine.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Back to the
Yes, Gaia. I'm just checking that this side of you is defended as well. It is. No assassins here.
Kluft, for many years you have been my faithful guard. But I do not require you to guard just myself. I require you to guard all of my creatures.
Excuse me one second.
Kluft.
Sorry.
That was my gardener.
Better safe than sorry.
As I was saying, you've done a fine job of guarding me from assassins and my gardener. But You have allowed my ex to lay waste to my precious creatures. Creatures of the north. Elephants and lions. Fair vultures that feed upon their entrails.
Oh, our national emblem is the vulture. It does harrow me so to see so many of them lying dead and then being fed off by other animals. Yes, I... Oh, I hear that it's happening again all around.
Those are my last two living vultures.
Oh, I see.
I try to keep them safe here in my throne room.
You're keeping them here, excellent. We'll need them to repopulate later. Oh. Oh. Poor gardener. There. I'll just close his mouth.
Kluft, tell me. We must think of a plan to defeat
Empress.
Plague
Lord. I have a plan. I spoke to a monk from the local monastery. The plague has struck even there. And as we speak, they're all falling foul of the plague as well. The last bastion of magical protection that we had from the monastery has gone. But before he died, he handed me a...
Thank you for this thing.
Before I die,
what was it called again? The name for it. Palimpsest.
No,
speak up. No, no, the pimple. The pimple.
Scarlet.
Spit it out.
Right. I'm just going to call it a scroll that's been rubbed out. Much simpler.
Back to the scene.
Yes, it's a scroll. That's had the writing rubbed out and then rewritten again. It's a map to the calipers of Arcturus.
Oh my god.
Remember these calipers that were lost so many years ago?
Sir Brian of Tyr, this is not just any map. Sir Kluft. I was calling you by your actor's name. Sir Kluft! This map.
Apparently we have banned all actors from our city.
This map.
No.
This map is the sacred minstrel's palimpsest.
Palimpsest. Sacred minstrel's palimpsest. How did I forget?
Did the monk not instruct you on how to reveal its hidden writings?
No, he died quite slowly. There was lots of like lots of fluids. He really couldn't talk very much.
Only a holy man knows how to unlock the secrets of such a paper. You must visit the monastery and see if there are any surviving monks. You must brave their plague, Sir Kluft.
Very well, but I will need something from you for this journey.
Well, I'll give you one of those big scary beaks full of herbs.
That will help, but to travel to the monastery and remain safe, I will need your 1971 green beak. Verily, I would not make this request if the need of North City weren't so dire.
Sir Kluft, we must defeat the Plague Lord, both for the elephants and for my honour.
Oh, Gaia. Well, if you insist.
Nice.
Right, Sir Kluft. Right to the monastery and find out how to keep both the palimpsest.
Come to the monastery. Yes, ordinary monk.
Was too plain with such magnificent legs.
Verily, we do follow the ways of the tyrannical god Rexatron.
Yes, Rexatron, who also died on a cross, which is why we had that cross today.
We see exactly how Rexatron died on a cross.
Rexatron, it is time for you to die. Get on this cross.
I do.
do this because I rule you all!
Impressive.
You see an enormous stained glass window, you're hitting that very scene.
Oh, Rexatron.
You're the most mechanical robotic of all the gods.
Hail Rexatron!
Hail Rexatron! King!
Rexatron!
Hail Rexatron! King Thelonious!
I hear approaching from the north.
The south? Yes, the north.
You have very good directional hearing.
The unmistakable sound of the Queen's Empress's 1972 Queen
Bill. Good Lord, we're going to have to cut short this service.
Ow! 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 Do you have to keep riding me? Ow! This really hurts!
She would only have released that in an event of greatest need. We are the only 2 months dead.
Alive.
I'm so near to death that sometimes I get things the wrong way.
You are old, you shall be offered to Rexatron.
Hey, Rexatron!
Hail Rexatron!
Hail Rexatron!
The lair of the plague
god. Oh, bring plague cluster.
I'm going to be teleporting away to a tree.
You're going to need to guard the entirety of the castle.
Yes. Oh, I will be so diligent guarding the castle.
Though you are, have no discernible skills. Very stupid. And whenever you see someone new, you scream in fear and run away. I'm sure you're the man for the job.
Yes. Truly knowing when to run away is the mark of the greatest
thing of all.
Yes.
Knowing when to run away, and for you it's all the time.
Yes, you look like they have no skills, you see.
But you're actually just very brave. Yes.
Oh, great playcaster, when shall you return?
Probably within moments. I can stand there, check if it's under that tree like the guy in the upstairs prison says it is. See if it's there, and in fact I'll just do it now.
Okay.
I want you to find out from the prisoner where it really is.
Okay.
Let me just show you a picture of him so you don't get scared. he looks like this. Now you're ready to be brave. Good luck.
Hello, friend!
Oh, great minstrel!
Can you sing like me?
Will I have to beat thee?
No! Don't beat me!
Then you shall tell me.
Tell you!
Where you've hidden your goods.
My goods! Why should I tell you where are my goods?
Goods, your goods. Cause if you don't, I'll put acid in your goods.
Fair point! I've hidden those calipers deep and far, deep and far, deep and far.
Could you be a little bit more precise?
Know of a pink tree?
Trees, again, yet again, just trees.
It has nothing to do with the trees. I messed your boss around.
Time.
me out. It is under the blue twig.
Blue twig.
As he moves to the gates of the monastery.
Who seeks entrance to the monastery of Rexatron?
Tell me, Dor, does this monastery have a valet service?
This monastery is equipped with all of the mod cums of Rexatron.
All hell!
Good. I need my 1971 green Buick to be parked somewhere safe while I speak to the abbot.
There is the valet. Please hand your keys to the valet.
Thank you!
I don't like the look of this valet!
Oh yeah, baby! The amateur Rexatron is not liable in any way for losses, damages. Buick as a result of using the service.
Can't you one, you Philistine? Like I'd be seen dead in 1972.
I'm glad that that is what caught your attention.
Is that your test to let me through into the monastery?
I was going to let you through anyway. But yes! Hey, Rexatron.
Abbott! Abbott, I need to speak to you at once. Ma'am, I speak as the emissary of the Empress Gear of North City, who, as you know, is the living I can't say words.
Do you mean Palimpsest?
The Palimpsest.
The Palimpsest.
Yes. One of your monks. Brought it all the way to North City as fast as your his dying guest.
I've been missing from my library for a week now.
Yes, well I brought it back for you.
An incredibly sexy monk took it with him. A really, really beautiful one. Reminds me of myself.
Classy. I can't imagine why.
You've travelled far, and I see you've taken the green 1971 Buick. This must indeed be important business on which you've been dispatched.
It is. I... No need to... Well, okay, very well. I am the most important of the Queen's guards, after all, and I have been entrusted with a very sacred duty to find Gears X and make him pay for the damage he has wrought to our fair land. For you see, it is Gears X that we believe is the plague caster. And he has sequestered himself away in a castle cave tower to the north.
Indeed, the castle cave tower to the north. We have heard tell of such a place, but never did we know where to find it. We never did even know in which direction it lay. The architect was mad. He says north could be anywhere. And as you know, all compasses don't work within the magic aura around the monastery. That's the main reason I should have said that.
This magic aura, is it still strong? Is it still...
Sorry guys, I think I might be lost. Is this a brothel?
What day is it today?
Abbott, explain yourself. It's Wednesday.
I travel.
No brothel today. Come back on Thursday.
I'll take you to the brothel. It's due. Oh dear, we're both completely lost. This compass is doing nothing.
Upwards.
Yes, gravity is also known sometimes. Stop working in my granddaddy, or as I like to call it, my kingdom, now that I've promoted myself to king.
Surely, king, I have come to seek your magic wisdom to help me, under the divine grace of Rexatron, all hail Rexatron, decode this palimpsest.
Indeed, I have heard it said that the original writing on this palimpsest is lost, and perhaps you could have travelled to the minstrel and asked him to... I'm sure my sexy monk would have advised you to travel to the minstrel and find out what it said, but given that you've not done that, I can tell you that
I heard on the magic winds the last song of the minstrel being sung. I fear that he no longer it will be around.
There it is now. I can hear it on the wind as well.
That's the end, yes.
I hit the rose colours. I hit the by a twig.
A twig.
A twig.
A twig.
Truly, this minstrel is gifted.
Acid time!
I believe that last part wasn't actually meant to be part of the minstrel song. No, so I know so much as that the calipers are hidden underneath the blue twig, but we don't know where that is either. That doesn't even have like a cardinal direction to start it. Fortunately, my rune table may be able to help us with that.
I see.
You see, I've put all these nicely coloured flags with the different runes on them in a pretty pattern. And I've disemboweled a chicken and sprayed its guts all over it.
And that's what that was.
So, if I get one of my assistant monks in to read the runes, because I'm an illiterate king, who knows what will happen. This is a crazy day, I mean.
Okay.
We're only literate enough to read one word at a time.
I trained the class for security purposes.
Very sensible, very sensible. Can't be too careful.
Exothor, Mexothor. Read the runes.
By
the
power
of
Rexatron.
Hail Rexatron!
Hail
Rexatron.
I
tell
you
that
the
caliper
is
hidden
by
the
blue
twig.
Twig
is
hidden
under
the
tower
of
plague.
Cave
unnamed. I see. That's very convenient. If you go to the cave plague tower, then we can find the blue twig, find the caliper, and then we'll be already in the place we need to be to use it. This will save us so much time. We'll be back in time for brothel day.
The plague did not know this information though, so he set out on a wild goose chase, teleporting to every blue twig he could find. The first of which was in America.
Well, howdy there, partner! Welcome to Obnoxious Sam's Gin Joint! We've got gin.
I completely lost. Oh, I know why. My compass broke.
Come back on Thursday.
You don't know where I could find a blue twig, do you?
A blue twig?
I mean, you have a crown that looks so like mine.
May I say how fine your crown is?
That's yours.
Indeed. Yes, a blue twig, you say?
Have you heard of any blue twigs recently? I really could do with a lead. Otherwise, it would take ages to teleport to every known compass point.
Why would you be seeking the blue twig, fair stranger with such excellent fashion sense? Except, excuse me, let me fix this.
No reason. I'm merely an ornithologist.
An ornithologist?
Studying blue tits. So I'm interested in blue twigs.
Oh, indeed, I was worried for a moment that
With such a solid alibi, you have to believe me.
I was worried that you might be the Dark Plague Lord.
No,
Rexatron.
No.
The one who killed our Lord Rexatron. Hail Rexatron!
Hail Rexatron! Dick! Yes. Sorry, that was a cough. Dick is a type of bird.
Truly, you are a fascinating
stranger. Yes, I know lots of things about birds.
Well,
given that you're not the Dark Plague Lord Lexithor, it seems there's no harm in telling you exactly where the only item we need to destroy that evil guy.
Which is irrelevant to me, but you might as well tell me.
Yes. But for science. Science and mythology.
I work for the University of Brexitron. Brexitron's noble brother who betrayed him for 50 gold Brexitron pieces.
At 12 experience points.
Yes, and now you're going to tell me about Midgekins.
I'm so sorry.
I get lost when I talk about the great Rexitron dick as well.
Please, the calipers are under the blue twig. The blue twig is in the cave plague tower castle complex.
I mean, the one that Lexitron lives in.
Yes.
How ironic.
I said.
I know. I'm afraid. I think if I. People I see in the dark birds. lucky I caught you at the right time. I killed that gate out there as well.
Like Two-Face, but more systematic.
Yes. 2.0 face, I call
it. Well, given that I've told you where you need to.
What a wonderful personality I've crafted for myself.
Yes. Will you be walking or teleporting?
I'll be teleporting, like all ornithologists.
I would advise.
It is the closest man can get to flight.
I would advise against teleporting within the grounds. You might come back wrong.
Well, I'll walk out past the gate, and then I'll teleport over to underneath the castle. Right. Thank you for the advice. What's your name, by the way?
My name is King Abbott.
Oh, King!
Yes, what's your name, sorry, ornithologist?
Oh, Billy Bird.
Billy Bird.
Pleasure doing business with you.
I do hope you meet again.
Yeah, me too.
We move to Lexitron's elaborate citadel, where Kluft is bravely infiltrating single-handedly.
Just guard this door then.
You there!
Guard it!
You! Lowly peasants!
penalties than I'd expected. Nope. This isn't locked.
Nope, it's fine.
You there! Announce yourself at once!
You didn't think it would be this easy to penetrate the great cave tower castle.
Well, so far I thought it would be a lot harder, actually. I've been woefully disappointed.
Well, you thought correctly. Lexitron keeps that fool boy around to entertain himself. He doesn't talk to me on account of my obnoxious personality. But I am very, very good at sword fighting.
Are you really?
Very, very good. I'm just great, you know. Sometimes I'm just having a bath and I just think, what?
They have a sword fight. Have at you, sir!
The fourth pushes you back against me, sir!
Tell me where the minstrel is.
The minstrel? You've come here seeking the minstrel.
Yes! Yes, I have! Oh, God!
The minstrel's dead! Hopeful of acid.
I'm too late!
I wasn't that good at sword fighting.
I was pleasantly surprised myself.
Meanwhile, Lexitron has teleported in upstairs.
I now spin when I teleport.
Well, most cherry Lexitron. Oh, I have great news. There is a man who's infiltrated the castle.
And you ran away from him, I presume.
I did.
Excellent.
As all unskilled men should.
And you sent our brave man who claims he's good at sword fighting.
Yes, the obnoxious guy. Yes.
Hey,
hate. Oh. I really hate it.
I fear that if they get hold of the calipers, they may cut short your attempts to destroy the entire universe.
Well,
with your plague.
They shan't be getting hold of the calipers, because I found out where they were. And I got them in my pocket. Nothing that looks like calipers. Here they are. Under the twig that was in the basement / forest. And here they are. Now how can they damage me when they're right next to me? I want you to lock them away somewhere safe. Safe.
Safe.
Now, not like safe when I said safe before and you dropped them off the tower.
No? You mean like lock them in the bathroom?
No, in the jail. We have a jail upstairs. Let's use it.
Right, okay. Let me take it to the jail.
You've got such a nice personality. At that very moment, Kluft has entered the jail and found the body of the minstrel. So greasy. This man has the distinct twinkle in his eye of a minstrel. That swordsman spoke true, I'm too late. Surely there's some kind of clue on his body.
Oh! You were here in the jail?
Well, 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 the coward returns.
Oh, yes. Oh, here we go.
Clutching a pair of calipers.
Yeah, no, I've got a job to do. Oh, yes, they're snapped together. Oh, I can't help but fiddle around with things I'm holding. I've got a job to do. If you'll excuse me, just going to put this in the jail.
Another step closer. That's right. Step back. Tell me, are these the calipers of Arcturus?
Yes.
They are. The very calipers that were used to hold the heads of our dear Lord Rexatron in place, while Lexatron electrocuted his face. The only calipers known that could suppress the head of Lexatron while we do the same thing to him.
You've come for the calipers, have you?
I've come for the calipers.
I'll fight you, but be warned! I'm a very bad swordsman. I'm very, very, very bad at it.
Is that so?
Which means that I'm very dangerous unilaterally.
To make this fair, I'll give you my sword.
I couldn't possibly lose from this situation. It would possibly be ironic, wouldn't it?
I will fight only with sharpened nails. That's right. Up on your feet, sir. I want a fair fight.
Oh, it's full of flesh wound.
Now,
I've got you, considering it's this.
Now that I've defeated you with my nails alone, tell me, where is Lexatron?
He's up. I mustn't tell you, he's upstairs.
Well, tell me where he is. Don't just tell me what you mustn't tell me, that's not going to help you at all.
He's upstairs, oh!
For this, I will let you live. I see a goodness in you. I see that you have been corrupted by Lexatron. Is this so? Your weak and spineless personality has led you to seek any kind of authority figure and follow him. Is this right?
Yes. When I was very young, my parents left me.
Aww.
It was a sad tale. And in the absence of an authority figure, the closest thing I could find was the Great Plague Lord.
You're lucky that all guards of North City take 2 years of psychoanalysis. Well, come with me, and we will see with these calipers.
that Lexatron's justice will finally be served after 60 long years of our dear Lord Rexatron being departed from this earth. We shall put this right. You and I, together.
Yes.
I was hoping to cut away from this moment.
Right.
We cut away from that moment! And into the chamber of Lexatron!
My chamber!
Hello again, Lexatron.
Gaia. Suddenly everything I hated you for disappears every time I see your beautiful face.
That's nice for you, Lexatron, but I'm still thinking of all my dead elephants.
What more do I have to kill to impress you, Gaia?
Lexatron, you never truly understood me. I think I can tell that from you.
I always understood you. Like when you told me to go out and get some toast, and so I killed my brother Rexatron. And then you said, we're breaking up, so I killed all the elephants that you love so much. I do everything for you.
Lexatron, I know you think you're doing good things. The truth is, you're completely insane.
Oh, I know I'm insane. I hated my brother Rexatron, and I hated those fucking elephants.
Lexatron, I know it was a bad deal for you that Rex got the god job.
All I was in charge of was plagues and told never to do one.
Lexatron, if only you could find something else you loved as much as plagues.
And then you, and then you left me!
Because of the plagues, Lexatron!
You said we were on a break, which I thought we should stand up!
Lexatron, I admit I came here because...
Gaia, what are you doing here?
I was looking in my viewing pool at my castle and I saw that you were close to completion. I wanted to be there when the final beat was done. I couldn't be away from the climax of this show.
Gaia, if I defeat him, will you be my evil ruler?
Lexatron,
I mean, the wife of me, the evil ruler. My evil ruleress, if you will.
Lexatron, I cannot agree. And there's no way you will defeat him, for he has something that you thought you had safely locked away.
No!
Click, click. Never thought I would send my assistant Midgekins with the important calipers. No, those are a dummy pair. I kept the real calipers in my pocket all along. But if I can't have you, then there's no point to anything. I'm just a brother killing, elephant killing dickhead. I won't even have a girlfriend. No, I'll do the world a favor. There'll be no more plagues.
Oh, Lexatron.
Electrocute me. Just do the good thing.
Kluft.
Fine, I'll electrocute myself.
No.
Death, Lexatron.
No, Rexatron!
Rexatron!
This was all part of my plan. For you to think you had killed me, to establish a religion around my death, that would create the abbey with all the magical things and establish the Minstrel and the Caliper and the Palimpsest and all the other things that happen in the Buick.
Of course I know that. I was playing along with our plan.
Yes.
We came to this planet 70 years ago and we set out with one goal. You would become the ruler. I would be in charge of the plagues. All we had to do was kill you, demonize me, and you're enshrined in heavens forever.
That's right, stupid mortals. My brother
knew what was going on. I knew what was going on.
People from the planet Exotron are far from you earthlings.
Indeed.
Lexatron, you are an alien all along. That explains so much.
Yes. I told you it's normally that small for us.
Brother, well, our work has been brought.
Shall we move on to Mars?
Yes, let us ascend to the heavens.
Okay, let's spin. Let's
And so it was that the minstrel's palimpsest had served its purpose. The great gods from the planet Exotron had brought peace and justice to the land. And they moved on to Mars. Ladies and gentlemen, we've been the Cambridge Impronauts. You've been a wonderful audience tonight. Thank you so much. If you've enjoyed the show, drop us on Facebook to find out more about it. And I will leave you only with the words. Hail Rexatron!
Hail!